Hey everyone, so here is my Flutter application output. I have two modes in my Flutter application. The one is text based and the another one is image based. Particularly in that image based level, if you upload that some UI design related thing like layout related things, so it will be provide that what we expect the code, so that full code it will be provided by the Gemini actually. And the text based, so if you ask any kind of queries, so it will be immediately will it written actually. So that is what in that application will do. So don't skip that video. We'll make the Flutter application with the Google Gemini together. All right. The first thing, to use the Gemini API, you will need an API key for accessing the Gemini API models actually. So if you don't have already one, create a new API key from the Google AI Studio and get a new key and implement in your code. All right, let's initialize the Flutter Gemini. Depending on the Flutter Gemini package, you can run this command flutter pub add and flutter Gemini. So that package will it create and then we'll start that code part. For initialization, you must call the init constructor for the Flutter Gemini in the main function actually. So here is the code. So after that, you can create an instance. Let's create stream generate content function actually. So when user provide that user prompt, that means the questions in that screen. So that values we need to pass through this function and that function will it send to the Google API, that API will it process and it will return that some response actually. So if the response is successful, we will be printing in the console. Otherwise, we will return that error actually. So this is what we did in that function. And the next thing in that function, we'll be applying that type animation widget and we'll see. To implement typing animation, you can use that Gemini response type widget actually. The Gemini response type widget allows you to present your search result using a typing animation, all without needs to utilize that set function actually. So like this, I mentioned in that code below. Text only input. This feature lets you perform natural language processing like NLP tasks such as text completion and summarization like that actually. So in that, I can just call the Gemini instance and in that, from the Gemini instance to, I can call the text function. So in that, I can just pass that my prompt, write a story about that some magic backpack, or you can pass that any user prompt from that Flutter URL actually. So all right. So once this text is sent to the Gemini API and it will be generated the content, after that, if no errors is happens, then it will be written that response. If any errors is occurs, then it will be written that error actually. So this is all about this code. The next thing, text and image input. If the input contains both text and image, you can send a text prompt with an image to the Gemini Pro Vision model to perform a vision related task. For example, I just show that in my output. So I can just simply attach my image along with that. So what is the picture like that? So immediately it will be returned that. So what is inside the picture and exactly what we expect the result. So that results we will getting from that Gemini API actually. So here's the sample snippet for that text and image inputs actually. So in that I can just call the Gemini instance along with that. I can call the text and image function actually. So in that, I can send a text prompt, what is this picture along with that image. So if the both will be sent to the Gemini API and once it's processed, it will be returned that response actually. So if that input is valid, then we'll be allowed to that. If anything happens, errors is occurs. So at that time, we'll be returned that errors for that actually. So this is some sample snippet for your reference. When using the long prompts, it might be useful to count tokens before sending any content to the model actually. If you get a model's URL, the API uses the get method to return the information about the model such as version, display name, input token, limit, etc. etc. If you need to get the model's directory, it uses the list method to list off all the models available through the API, including the both Gemini and Palm family models also. Alright, so this is my final output for my all the pages like text-based and image-based like that actually. And I attach the complete that code base. So in my Git, so that Git link I added in the description below. So you can take the code and you can play with whatever you want actually. So it's up to you guys actually. So hope you guys, you really like that video. If you really like that video, please subscribe my channel for more videos like this in the future. And also, if you have any queries or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. I'm happy to respond and we'll see you on the next video. Thank you. Bye.